everyone, Justin here, and I just got back from ordering a pizza at my local pizza place. Oh, I am so hungry. You know, the pizza in my neighborhood is actually pretty famous. People come from all over just to try it and see if it's worth it. And spoiler alert, it totally is. Oh no, I'm teaching right now. And this is a good thing. You know, lots of people work in these pizza places and make a living there, helping people who walk around saying, pizza, pizza, must have pizza. It's a pretty important part of the economy around here. You know, I always thought that maybe one day I would go around trying all the different pizzerias and seeing how they compare. You know, if pizza places are so important in my neighborhood, I wonder what it's like in other regions of the United States. What are their economies like? What industries support the people living there? Let's discover that together. Welcome to today's episode of Operation Exploration, where we will explore regions of the United States. In this video, we are going to be exploring some of the industries, economies, and natural resources found in the Northeast region of the United States. The states that make up this region that we're going to be talking about today are Maine, Vermont, New Hampshire, Massachusetts, Connecticut, Rhode Island, New York, Pennsylvania, and New Jersey. Maybe you already live in one of these states and know some of the things that we're going to discover today. Despite being known for some of the biggest cities in the country, like New York and Boston, the Northeast region is also home to some incredible farms. New Jersey, for instance, is known as the Garden State. It's home to more than 10,000 farms where fruits and veggies such as tomatoes, peaches, and squash are grown. Want to put some of these fruits and veggies into a salad? Add some mushrooms from Pennsylvania. Pennsylvania grows more mushrooms than any other state. You know what Pennsylvania also makes? Chocolate. Chocolate's it's about as yummy as, say, pizza, huh? Don't you think? As long as we're talking about food, New York is home to plenty of apple farms. People ship apples from New York all over the country. New York is also home to rolling hills filled with cows, dairy cows. Plenty of dairy products are made in New York, like milk, cheese, and my favorite, ice cream. Ice cream. Oh, and Vermont has plenty of dairy too. Vermont is also the largest producer of maple syrup in the country. Wow, so many delicious foods are made right here in the Northeast. Speaking of delicious, in Maine, the soil is perfect and the climate is just right to grow potatoes. Also, Maine is known for its blueberries. There's close to 500 farms in Maine that grow these yummy berries for us to enjoy. Hold on, we're not done with yummy or berries quite yet. Another Northeastern state, Massachusetts, has the perfect climate and land to grow another kind of berry, cranberries. These grow in large, wet areas of land called bogs. Since a lot of the Northeast region is on the Atlantic Ocean, it's also known for its lobsters, oysters, fish, and other kinds of seafood. Many people work as fishermen, bringing in seafood to ship all across the US. Besides food products, many Northeastern states have other natural resources that people use to bring money into the area. Because of the large areas covered in forests, Maine and New Hampshire have the largest forested areas of any state, the manufacturing of lumber and paper products is a huge industry in this area. What's an industry, you may ask? Well, an industry is basically whatever people do for work, be it making things to sell or providing services. New Hampshire is actually called the Granite State. Can you guess why it got this nickname? It's because of its granite quarries. Many people earn a living by going to these quarries and hauling off granite that's used to make curbs, walls, buildings, and countertops. The Library of Congress, located in Washington, D.C., was built using 30,000 tons of granite mined from New Hampshire. Like much of the country, the Northeast region has seen many of its factories give way to an economy of high tech. A lot of people here work to design computer networks and other broadband communications. These computer programs and systems are also used in another booming industry in the Northeast, healthcare. Be it in hospitals, clinics, or health centers, many people in the Northeast earn a living working in the healthcare field. Another important industry in the Northeast is tourism. Plenty of people flock from all over to check out the big cities here, as well as to see the beautiful trees when the leaves change color in the fall. In fact, people who come up just to see the leaves change are often called leaf peepers. Plus, the cold, snowy winters bring people up to ski and snowboard, too. But let's not stop there. There are plenty of industries that don't totally depend on tourism, technology, or healthcare. If an area doesn't snow or grow, it makes things. The entire Industrial Revolution started here in the 1700s. Rhode Island used water to power its mills and machines in order to make textiles. Although, if you think about it, using water power kind of is using an important natural resource, right? And hey, textiles are made out of plant products. I guess these new tech industries kind of rely on the snow and grow a bit more than just for a beautiful holiday, right? What other goods does the Northeast produce? Money. Pennsylvania's mint is the oldest producer of coins in the US, and it's still making coins that people around the country have jingling in their pockets today. And speaking of money, Wall Street in New York City is the financial center of the US. You know what else is an important industry in this region? Education. There are tons of colleges and universities located in the Northeast. Harvard University in Massachusetts was the very first college for higher education in the country. And you know what college students love to eat? Pizza. You know, there are probably tons of other important industries that I didn't even get to talk about. Like, what's the economy like where you live? What sorts of companies or industries employ people in your state? Maybe it's pizza shops.
Oh, that was so good.
I bet you could do your own research and find some things that I didn't get to talk about in this video. So, thank you for stopping by today. I'll see you all soon. And in the meantime, remember to always be clever. Oh, you were worth the wait.